I'm on top of the world, hey. I'm on top of the world, hey. Waiting on this for a while now. Paying my dues to the dirt. I've been waiting. Good morning, students. Welcome back from the holiday breaks. I hope you all had a wonderful time. You spent time with loved ones and friends, and you got some time to rest and rejuvenate for this next part of your academic year. As we move forward to second semester, I hope that you all focus on your grades, your preparation for the upcoming EOC exams, and if some of you have lost credit, you need to focus on recovering that credit before the end of the year. Sooner is better than later. Any questions on your grades, on attendance, please come see your counselors or the assistant principal or myself. You don't want to wait till the end to be worried about passing to the 10th grade. Our conversations today, however, I want to focus on something else. I want to focus on goals. As we start this new year, we often have New Year's resolutions, things that we want to, goals that we want to set for ourselves, and that's really where the focus of this video is going to be about. As you get older, all of your young men and young ladies, you need to start thinking of what it is that you want out of life. And perhaps some of you are very clear on what you want. You have direction, you have purpose, you know what you want after high school. Some of you, you have a couple of options, you're not sure, and that's okay. And some of you probably have not even given it any thought. Well, if that's the case, you need to give it thought. I hate to tell you, but you're not children anymore. You are young men and young women. And as time goes by, you need direction. You need to have a focus in your life. You need to know what it is that you want after high school. And that's not for me to tell you or for anybody else to tell you. It's for you to decide, something that's going to give you a sense of fulfillment, a sense of satisfaction, something that you're going to be proud of. And we're all different, and so success is different for all of us. But you need to have a game plan. It's okay to change your mind. You are still young. It's not okay not to be thinking about it. For example, one of my daughters wanted to be a mermaid. She's changed her mind since then. All right. I want you to see a video about a couple of gentlemen that exemplify finding something to do with their life that they have a sense of satisfaction with. So we take a few minutes, you're going to watch that video, and then we'll come back together.
I guess it all started when my dad brought home a Suzuki RM60 from a guy that he worked with. It was trial by fire for Tim and I, first experience with a motorcycle being a two-stroke with a clutch. But we wrecked that thing more times than I can count. And being from Ohio, not a lot of, especially Northwest Ohio, not a lot of distractions up here. Cornfields, flat ground. Basically, anything with a motor became our escape from boredom.
Our dad would be like, you know, if it breaks, figure out how to fix it. He wasn't the guy to say, oh, let's just bring it to the shop and, you know, pay someone to do it. Figure out how to work on it.
After a while, you started to enjoy working on the stuff. And it was like, oh, I can fix this thing, or I can buy this real cheap from somebody down the road and get it running, and then, oh, I got another dirt bike, I got a mini bike, I got a ATV. And so pretty soon we had like a shop full of toys for like no money, basically because we were the guys that enjoyed working on the stuff.
I really think that that started from, you know,
very early age.
Yeah, very young. I got a Yamaha XS650 when I was about 16, and we bought it from this guy, and he had another one that was in his barn that caught on fire, and he's like, oh, here's some parts bike you can have for 200 more bucks. That junk one was just sitting there staring at me all the time, you know, like, and I'm like, you know, let's do something with this thing. There's nothing really to lose, so I'm like, chop it in half. We started working on it like my senior year of high school. We wanted to get it done by the time I graduated, have it at my graduation party, show people, like, you know, we built something. Started putting like pictures online, showing people what we did on forums and stuff, and everyone's like, oh, if you made that frame, I'd buy it, or you make those four controls, I'd buy them. So we made a couple batches, like small batches of each part, threw them up on eBay, and they sold out almost instantly. So that was really like the turning point where we're like, maybe we could do this as a job.
We started making, you know, more and more stuff, and made a little website and whatever. And it's like, we started getting pretty busy. And it's like, well, maybe we got a better chance of really going somewhere with this. We started putting more and more effort into it. And pretty soon we're working more at home than we were at work, and it was not gonna lie, it was tough. Those first couple of years getting it off the ground with minimal resources was a struggle for sure. Once we finally got to dive in full time and hire a couple employees, really it started picking up, and things have gotten a lot smoother after that. But still, we're 10 years later now where we can say that, but we definitely put our blood, sweat, and tears into it in the beginning. Doing what you love every day, that's
awesome.
I couldn't be happier, and I owe that all to our customers, you know. I mean, everything, being able to come in and do that every day, how can you complain about that?
A few things that I wanted you to take from the video that you just saw. First of all, I hope that you captured that they really started their business while they were still in high school. It was towards the latter part of their senior year that they built their first motorcycle and that they started selling their parts on eBay. Okay, so I mentioned that because a lot of times we think that our future and our careers are many, many years down the line, and that's not necessarily the case. Next thing I want you to take from that video is that there was a sense of satisfaction and fulfillment on behalf of the two individuals. They were very happy with what they have accomplished, and they should be. And that's what I want for each and every single one of you. A sense of fulfillment, a sense of satisfaction in the career that you have chosen. Third, I want you to realize, as they said, it takes work. There's effort. I think they used the term, had the blood, sweat, and tears to get their business going. Anything that you want out of life is going to take effort. So there's no way around that. There's no shortcuts. Okay? I want you to also understand that even though the path for success is going to be different for all of you, and that's okay, what is a common goal for each and every single one of you is that you must first get your high school diploma. That is step one for each and every single one of you. And on that particular path, all of you are on already. Again, Happy New Year. I hope 2018 is a wonderful year for you and all your friends and your loved ones. I wish you all success, and however we can help, myself and my staff are here to help you. Have a good day.
I've tried to cut these corners, try to take the easy way. I kept on falling short of something. I could have gave up then, but then again I couldn't have, 'cause I've traveled all this way for something. I take it in, but don't look down. 'Cause I'm on top of the world, hey.